Hi, good morning. My name is Ramesh Shetty, working as Assistant Professor of Mathematics, Government First Aid College, Tiptur. Today, I am going to explain partial differential equations in the form of f of x, comma p is equal to g of y, comma q, or f1 of x, comma p is equal to g f2 of y, comma q. So, in previous classes, I already explained the partial differential equations of the form of f of pq is equal to 0, it contains only p and q, and f of p comma q comma z is equal to 0, which contains p, q and z only. So this is of third type equations of the form f1 of x comma p is equal to f2 of y comma q. The equations in which the variable z is absent here and the terms involving p and x can be separated from those containing q and y can be written in the form of f1 of x comma p is equal to f2 of y comma q. This is a third type of different partial differential equation. So working rule is f1 of x comma p is equal to f2 of y comma q. That the given equation is f1 of x comma p is equal to f2 of y comma q. Put f1 of x comma p is equal to f2 of y comma q is equal to a, where a is constant. You express p as f of x comma a and q as g of y comma a. Substitute the values of p and q in the given in the equation dz is equal to p into dx plus q into dy, and integrate. We obtain the complete solution of the given partial differential equation. So this is of type 3 equation of the form f1 of x comma p is equal to f2 of y comma q. The equations in which the variable z is absent here and the terms involving p and x can be separated from those containing q and y can be written in the form of f1 of x comma p is equal to f2 of y comma q. Working rule, let the given differential equation is f1 of x comma p is equal to f2 of y comma q. Put f1 of x comma p is equal to f2 of y comma q is equal to a, where a is constant. And express p is equal to f of x comma a and q is equal to g of y comma a. And that means p in terms of x comma a and q in terms of y comma a. Substitute the values of p and q in the differential equation dz is equal to p into dx plus q into dy, and integrate. We get the complete solution of the given differential equation. Solve the differential equation of p square minus q square is equal to x minus y. So this is the given differential equation, and separate the p and x and q and y on both sides. So this implies p square minus x square is equal to q square minus y square. So the equation can be written as p square minus x is equal to q square minus y square. So put p square minus x equal to a and q square minus y is equal to a. So p square is equal to x plus a, and q square is equal to a plus y. P is equal to root of a plus x and q is equal to root of a plus y. Putting these values of p and q in the given differential equation, in the equation dz is equal to pdx plus q into dy, we get. So dz is equal to root of a plus x into dx plus root of a plus y into dy is equal to dz. So this is variable separable differential equation. So after integration, it becomes 2 by 3 a plus x over to the power of 3 by 2 plus 2 by 3 a plus y over to the power of 3 by 2 is equal to z plus c. R multiply by 3, we get 2 into x plus a over to the power of 3 by 2 plus a plus y over to the power of 3 by 2 is equal to 3z plus k. This is the required solution of the partial differential equation. Once again, the given equation is p square minus q square is equal to x minus y. The given equation can be written as p square minus x equal to q square minus y. Or you put p square minus a is equal to p square minus x equal to a and q square minus y is equal to a. or put p is equal to root of a plus x and q is equal to root of a plus y. Putting these values in the given equation, in the differential equation, dz is equal to pdx plus q dy, we get root of a plus x dx plus root of a plus y dy is equal to dz. And integrating, we get 2 by 3 a to the power a plus x over to the power of 3 by 2 and plus 2 by 3 a plus y over to the power of 3 by 2 is equal to z plus c. Or 2 into a plus x over to the power of 3 by 2 plus a plus y over to the power of 3 by 2 is equal to 3z plus k. This is the solution of the given differential equation. Second problem, same type problem, root p plus root q is equal to x plus y. The given equation can be written as root p minus x equal to y minus root q. So, on the put that is equal to a. Root p minus x equal to a and root y minus root q is equal to a. Or p is equal to a plus x over to the power of 2 and q is equal to y minus a over to the power of 2 whole square. So, given equation is root p plus root q is equal to x plus y. Then the equation can be written as root p minus x equal to y minus root q. Or root p minus x equal to a and y minus root q is equal to a. Or p is equal to a plus x whole square and q is equal to y minus a whole square. Substitute the values of p and q in the equation dz is equal to pdx plus q d into dy. Or dz is equal to a plus x whole square into dx plus y minus a whole square into dy. On integrating, we get z is equal to a plus x whole cube by 3 plus y minus a whole cube by 3 plus k. Multiply by 3, we get 3z is equal to a plus x whole cube plus y minus a whole cube plus c, which is the required solution of the given differential equation. So, substituting the values in the differential equation, dz is equal to pdx plus q into dy. Dz is equal to p is a plus x whole square dx plus y minus a whole square into dy. On integrating, z is equal to a plus x whole cube by 3 plus y minus a whole cube by 3 plus k. Or 3z is equal to a plus x whole cube plus y minus a whole cube plus c. This is the required solution of the given partial differential equation. Solve the equation p plus q is equal to sin x plus sin y. This is also same type of problem, third type. So, it contains p, q and x and y. Z is absent. So, this equation can be written as p minus sin x equal to sin y minus q. P minus sin x equal to a and sin y minus q is equal to a. Or p is equal to a plus sin x q is equal to sin y minus a. Substitute the values of p and q in the equation dz is equal to p into dx plus q into dy. Or dz is equal to p is a plus sin x into dx plus y, sin y minus a into dy. So, on integrating, this is a variable separable differential equation. On integrating, we have z is equal to ax minus sin x is cos x minus cos x plus minus cos y minus ay plus c. Or z is equal to ax minus cos x minus cos y minus ay plus c. Or this implies z is equal to a into x minus y minus cos x plus cos y plus c, which is the required solution of the given differential equation. Solve the equation p plus q is equal to sin x plus sin. The given equation can be written as p minus sin x equal to sin y minus q. Or p minus sin x equal to a sin y minus q is equal to a. P is equal to a plus sin x and q is equal to sin y minus a. Substitute the values of p and q in the equation dz is equal to pdx plus q dy. Or dz is equal to a plus sin x into dx plus sin y minus a into dy. On integrating, we have dz is equal to ax minus cos y minus cos y minus a y plus c. Or z is equal to a into x minus y minus cos x plus cos y plus c, which is the required solution of the given differential equation. So, once again, the given equation is p plus q is equal to sin x plus sin y. P minus sin x equal to sin y minus q. P minus sin x equal to a and sin y minus q is equal to a. P is equal to a plus sin x and q is equal to sin y minus a. Or dz is equal to pdx plus q dy. Substituting all the values in the given equation, dz is equal to a plus sin x into dx plus sin y minus a into dy. On integrating, we get z is equal to ax plus ax minus cos y minus cos x minus cos y minus ay plus c. Or z is equal to a into x minus y minus cos x plus cos y plus c, which is the required solution of the given partial differential equation. Next problem is solve yp plus x into q plus pq is equal to 0. This is also in the form of third type containing x, y, p and q. It is z is here absent. The given equation can be written as q into x plus p is equal to minus yp. Q into x plus p is equal to minus yp. Or x plus p by p is equal to minus y by q. So here p and x are one side and q and y are one side. So x plus p by p is equal to a minus y by q is equal to a. P is equal to a x divided by a minus 1. And q is equal to minus y by a. So substitute the values of dz in the equation. Dz is equal to p dx plus q dy. Dz is equal to x by a minus 1 into dx plus minus y by a into dy. On integrating we have. So the given equation can be written as, once again, q into x plus p is equal to minus yp, and x plus p divided by p is equal to minus y by q, and x plus p by p is equal to a, and minus 1 by minus y by q is equal to a. This implies p is equal to x by a minus 1 and q is equal to minus y by a. We have dz is equal to p dx plus q dy. Then dz is equal to x by a minus 1 into dx plus minus y by a into dy. On integrating we have z is equal to x square by 2 into a minus 1 plus minus y square by 2a plus. See, this is the required solution of the given differential equation. So next problem is p square minus y cube into q is equal to x square minus y square. X square minus y square. So this is also in the form of p f of p comma x equal to g of q comma y. And here also that is absent. The given equation can be written as p square minus x square is equal to y cube q minus y square. So p square minus x square is equal to y cube q minus y square. So here p and x are one side and q and y are one side. P square minus x square is equal to a square, and y square q minus y square, y cube q minus y square is equal to a square. Or p is equal to root of a square plus x square, and q is equal to a square plus y square by y cube. Substitute the values of p and q in the equation. Dz is equal to pdx plus q into dy. Or dz is equal to square root of a square plus x square dx plus a square plus y square by y cube into dy. On integrating we get z is equal to x into root of a square plus x square by 2 plus a square by 2 sine hyperbolic inverse x by a plus log y minus a square by 2y square plus c. This is the solution of the given differential equation. So once again, the equation can be, given equation can be written as p square minus x square is equal to y cube q minus y square. P square minus x square equal to a square, and y cube q minus y square is equal to a square. P is equal to root of a square minus x square. Q is equal to a square plus y square by y cube. Substitute the values of p and q in the differential equation. Dz is equal to pdx plus q dy. So dz is equal to square root of a square plus x square into dx plus a square plus y square by y cube into dy. On integrating we have, on integrating z is equal to x into root of a square plus x square by 2 plus a square by 2 into sine hyperbolic inverse x by a plus log y minus a square by 2y square plus c. This is the complete solution of the given differential equation. So in this way we find the solution of the given differential equation of the type f of x comma q, f of x comma p is equal to y of q comma y. So here the major steps are, first you have to express the given equation in the form of f of x comma p is equal to g of y comma q, and substitute this is equal to a f of x comma p is equal to g of y comma q is equal to a, and then express p in terms of x and a and q in terms of y and a, and then substitute the values of p and q in the differential equation, and dz is equal to pt express q dy, and then integration, we get the complete solution of the given differential equation. So these are the some problems related to third type, f1 of p comma x equal to f2 of q comma y. Thank you.